just yelling because they're yelling. You don't know what I said, so it doesn't count. That was a beer yell. Beer yells don't count.
One of the things that comes along with coaching for a lot of years is a very strong voice. So if we had to yell off the first three, I know they would win. Ready to go, round two, second half. First time these two teams have played each other, we've got Spasmataz and Chariot of Fire.
27-point game, 117 Angels in purple, 90 for your Gas City Rollers in green, and it's Chariot of Fire picking up where she left off. In fact, it's both her and Spaz picking up right where we left off at halftime. This time with Cherry out of the pack with lead, Spaz not too far behind. Cherry jumps in the back and calls it off. Ooh. We got...
Absolutely. Spaz takes the back block and will go to the penalty box for a minute for being a bad girl.
I believe that was a major. I believe that was a major.
And we're back to this with the new rule set as of January 1st of this year. There are no minor penalties. All penalties called will result in a trip to the penalty box. Yet, we still...
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Royal LePage's Glenn Newhouse, Panorama Lane's Family Fun Center, Danny the Car Guy at City Chrysler, and Community Television Medicine Hat.
Jesse Jinx out there jamming for the Archangels. She does break through the pack. And an unfortunate Gas City Roller called an out-of-play major. Nice work by Jesse Jinx to push the pack forward.
And right at the moment they called no pack, the blocker for Gas City still engaging physically with the jammer, and that's a penalty.
And you must attempt to reform the pack immediately once no pack is called. Just like that.
Well done, ladies. Well done.
So this is a pretty strong power jam for the Archangels. And absolutely, green skated away from purple and were unable to engage the jammer. So they did not read that well. They broke the pack. Spaz is now through with her first pass. And Spaz will take her 1 point, so good job. Never give up is the order of the day. Never give up.
Archangels, 91 Gas City. First 2 minutes of the second and final half of this game.
Chow Ming jamming for the Gas City Rollers, and we've got Jaded Empire out there for the Archangels. And she sees that big door on the inside, runs through it to take lead jam. So the Archangels did a nice setup for her, and she took good advantage. And nice work by Jaded Empire on her first scoring pass, takes the natural grand slam. Purple is doing a lot of work right now on Chow Mean. And now Green pushes out Jaded Empire. She will have to recycle back in at the very back of the pack. And she calls off the jam.
So a couple jams in here, and whatever adjustment the Archangels have made, they're taking advantage of. Gas City has scored 1 point since the second half has started, as the Angels continue to put points on. Even if they chip away with 3 and 4 point jams, Gas is going to need help from a power jam or to get some leads back to back here to get back close the gap.
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Outlaw Collision, Amron Homes, Medicine Hat Refrigeration, and the Gas City Roller Derby Association.
Sting jamming for the Archangels.
I am one of those melodramatic fools.
And nice closing the door on Spaz, but BB Sting is back there with a big fight on her hands. No problem, she says. She's now also out of the pack. And nice work by BB Sting all the way through the pack. And the jammers are having a tete-a-tete. A little chat. Friendly, of course. And again, Baby Sting goes through. And she is loving it. Some really nice pack work by Purple. And Spaz ends up on the wrong end of that jam. So we've got Trickster and Tipsy Gypsy out there for Gas City and the Archangels. Swiss Army Roy getting ready to call this jam down. Tipsy Gypsy doing a lot of work. And Tipsy indeed does get called for either the forearms or the back block. She had to fight her way through the pack, but unsuccessfully, since she took the penalty doing it. So this will give Gas City a power jam.
Oh, Cherry almost forced a cut major there by that hip check out of bounds. And,
Green is now going with Purple, and they turned around. Green went with Purple and then turned around, but there was no infraction called. So Green Jammer's still away. She's got four blockers out there to help her. Purple is down to two on the track. So we have a full penalty blocks for the Archangels right now.
Trickster comes around again for another grand slam, and this is the opportunity that Gas City needed.
Absolutely.
Taking their score up to 110, I believe, 109 Gas City.
That will definitely put some points on the board, and they will start this next jam with an advantage as well. And there is a contest called by the captain, Petrify. So she will contest the call on pack formation, reformation. I already know that.
I believe so. Official review is being taken by the Archangels.
So we've got Swiss Army Roy working out.
He says, do you want to go to the zoo? I think is what he said. Yeah.
So official review is being signaled by Swiss Army Roy. Let's talk about our sponsors one more time.
All right, I want to thank Bad Girlfriend Skates out in Vendors Alley. Go check them out. Rapscallion's also there as well. Purist Welding Services. If you need to weld something to something, go see Purist Welding Services. Booster Juice. Ronco. Is that the same Ronco that makes like that spray-on hair, or is that another company? Ronco. Visual Musings. Number 5 Welding. So you got welding options now. Nerd Skates. Morrison Health. The Gas and Rollers official sports therapist. Rollergirl.ca, Kurt's Ironworks, and Pharaoh's Pizza, which is at Bourbon Street, the official after party for tonight at the Coast Hotel, our host hotel, Bourbon Street, the GCRDA official after party venue. Come and check it out. Meet a Derby person, buy them a drink.
And remember, if you're interested in getting involved in what you see, Gas City could always use more volunteers, more referees, and more skaters. Remember that roller derby is the fastest growing sport for women in the world right now. If you would like to get on board.
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Hemptown Rock, Icy Mountain Water Company, Animal World, and the Gas City Roller Derby Association.
Swiss Army Roy doing a fantastic job of signaling the official review.
I like the pointing. It's quite a good pointer.
Yes. I have a dog who's a good pointer.
And he can use a stopwatch. Do we know what the official review is about? Do you come and tell us?
No, we don't know what the official review is about, but I am making a guess. It's probably about pack formation, reformation. So maybe wanting faster calls. It's been tough, and I actually spoke to Fluster briefly at the half, and the packs have been expanding, shrinking. It's tough to keep an eye on it because you don't want to call no pack, and then pack is here 50 times a jam. So you really want to let the girls kind of figure it out and sort it out.
All right. But the reformation requires the front pack to stop and the back pack to hustle forward. And I think that might be some of the conversation. I'm not. I've explained this too much today to too many people. I'm going to explain it one more time.
Yes, if you're coaching and then you're actually calling the game, that could be a little bit problematic.
11 minutes left in the game.
We'll have this official review wrapped up, hopefully to the satisfaction of everyone right away. We'll get back on the track and get rolling. A little over 10 minutes left in the second half. Remember, the after party will be at the Coast Hotel where you will get delicious Pharaoh's pizza.
So just to give people an idea of how big roller derby is right now, well, there's already been 10 bouts completed today in Australia. The leagues in Australia have got all their games going. There are games played in New Zealand today, in South America, games played in Europe, overseas today. Saturday is a very busy roller derby day. There's probably over 100 bouts or 100 leagues involved in 100 bouts just like this all over the planet today, involving over 200 to 300 teams, which means about 600 to 700 skaters, not including the add in the extra people that NSO and referees, there's thousands of people in this last 24 hours around the planet either taking part in roller derby or watching roller derby. So we want to thank you for supporting the fastest growing women's sport in the world.
Absolutely.
Give yourselves a hand. Clap! Clap your hands now! Don't make me come out there. Don't make Dr. Sting come out there. That won't be nice.
Don't face the wrath of Mac the Mouth and Dr. Sting.
Dr. Sting has cold hands. Don't make him come out there. If he asks you to cough, just head back to the car. Well, things have seemed to have ground to a steady, motionless portion of the game. Swiss Roy doing figure eights. It's almost time for Swiss Roy to... Oh, 5 seconds. I think if he yells 5 seconds, you know what that means.
5 seconds to jam time. No pack is called, and they will have to let the jammer go. Tipsy Gypsy back on for the Archangels. Petrify called on the back block major, so she will go to the penalty box.
Spaz calling it off, and Angels not getting in there in time to steal any points.
Not quite.
Taking the lead, the gap in the lead, down to 42 points. 155 Archangels, 113 Gas City.
8 minutes left. Both teams well over the century mark now. Looks like Chow Mein, and I think Genuine Draft. Yes, it is. And Genuine Draft is through on the outside. Chalmeen recycled to the inside. Opposite directions. And Star ends up with the better of it. And Genuine Draft just slips through two blockers like a hot knife through butter, and there she goes again.
Like a warm spoon through margarine.
And Chalmeen is getting worked over by the Archangels. And Six Pack is having a free skate on this jam. She shows no sign of wanting to stop. It's a solid jam by Six Pack, Genuine Draft. Some really nice work from the blockers in purple to hold back the green jammer. And some nice hard work finishes on turn number...
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Royal LePage's Glenn Newhaus, Panorama Lane's Family Fun Center, Danny the Car Guy at City Chrysler, and Community Television Medicine Hat.
Ah, great blocking by those two blockers. Swiss Army Roy apparently is a liar. There's 8 minutes left now. It's probably on Central Time. Oh, no, we are. No, we're not.
Mountain Standard. That's okay, you West Coasters, I tell ya. Every time you come out here, you wonder, why did I come out here? So much nicer. Jessie Jinks working her way at the front of the pack. There's a bunch of green blockers up there. She manages to sneak by them. Oh! And unfortunately... Trickster takes the cut track, and she will have to go to the penalty box. Very nearly stayed out.
That's an ill-timed penalty. Gas City needs to keep their jammers on the track here to close that gap. It's 56 points. This is not going to go in their favor this time of the game.
So Jessie Jinks is away with lead jam, and she's got her skaters lined up. She will have to do some work on that three wall, and she does manage to sneak by. And a very brisk out-of-play major called on 1-2-3, so one more blocker going to the penalty box, at least two out for Jessie Jinks. And a sweeping play by Baby Sting. Just about didn't work, but Jessie Jinks was able to counter that. And again, Jessie Jinks approaching the back of the pack for scoring pass. So still up there, number 14, skating and showing no signs of slowing down. I remember when Jessie Jinks first skated with us with Evil Roller Derby about 4.5 years ago, she broke her leg about 1 year into her career and came back from that and started skating with Star again about a year ago. It's good to see her back on the track tonight.
Well, that's another five on top of the end of that jam. Strong jam. By Jessie Lynx. Jinx. Your Jalen Sigonell. 171, 177, 113. Is that Leo? Sorry, 178. I'll wait till that thing's done. 65 points. Gassy's gonna need some help from the jammers in purple here. We're getting low on time. Oh.
I think that the big story in the second half here has been the purple blockers just holding on to that green jammer, and so frustrating as a jammer because you work so hard, it tires you out, and then you're watching the other jammer go by. So really, purple has done a great job of that. Green's got to respond. They've got to help their jammer get out a little quicker and also get right on top of that purple jammer if they want to be effective in the last bit of the game here.
Yeah, and with lead, you get control, and now it's time. It's clock management right now. Time is in favor of the Archangels right now.
Oh,
pretty good. I mean, Swiss told us about 5 minutes ago there's 8 minutes left, and he just informed us that when the jam starts, there's 7.5 minutes.
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Outlaw Collision, Amron Homes, Medicine Hat Refrigeration, and the Gas City Roller Derby Association.
Oh, I'm glad Target's coming back to Canada. Looks like three blockers aside, so there's a little bit more skating room right now. We'll see what happens with the jammers. I think we've got Jaded Empire out there, and who we got?
Yeah, just based on that jump in the air, that would be Spaz back there on the jam line.
A little less than 8 minutes left to go in this half. Got Spaz and Jaded Empire out there jamming for Gas City and the Archangels. Swiss Army Roy blows it down, and his jam is on. Some strong pushing at the back there from Jaded Empire, and she muscles by with a nice whip off of Petrify. Spaz is going to engage.
All right.
Nice job, both by Jaded Empire and Spaz. Play defensively, getting through the pack and forcing Jaded to call that off.
And more time ticks off that clock that Gas City sorely needs. Plus, give me a power jump. It would help tighten things up here. Dark Angels are pushing the edge of 200 points with 199 to 113.
Looks like Genuine Draft and Trickster out there for the Archangels in Gas City. And there's a lot of green up at the front. And JD runs past them. Purple Blockers reforming, taking a look, and they stop 08. And some fantastic hip check work by Cherry down on turn four.
Forcing her to cycle all the way to the back of the pack and start again, getting up to those eight skaters.
That gives Genuine Jaff a chance to cut through.
A nice hit out by Cherry there.
And we do have a skater down on one knee, slow to get up. Out of respect and courtesy, skaters will take a knee until that skater rises to leave the track. She's talking it out with the coach. Alberta Health Services at the ready. Awesome. All's well. 1-2-3 will take a well-earned break on the bench. Hopefully not hurt badly. Got Tipsy Gypsy and I believe Spaz out there. And it's a melee out there. Looking like some serious rugby on skates. Spaz is away with Lee Jam. Tipsy is also out of the pack. Jesse Jinx does get the low block call on that hit on Spaz. And Tipsy Gypsy and Spaz are both still skating out there. Looking for some ghost points, but I don't think we'll get any there. And some nice coaching on turn two by Kim Janet. It's all Matt can do not to yell into the microphone. He's doing so awesome.
By the way, the Rag Girls beat the Faster Pussycat.
Gas City Roller Derby brought to you by Hemptown Rock, Icy Mountain Water Company, Animal World, and the Gas City Roller Derby Association.
Sting and Trickster out there jamming for the Archangels in Gas City.
Direction of play call on 2-4-1. Just as you stopped, it skated in the wrong. You can only skate in one direction of play to make contact.
And I think that is the first time this evening we've seen a directional play call. In fact, we haven't seen a whole lot of calls in the game. I think it's been fairly even. Both teams have played fairly well. Unfortunately, the jammers have been taking a lot of penalties. We've seen lots of power jams, both in the first and second half.
Trickster just took a big hit, had to stop and collect herself there. It's tough going through that pack. Not going to get any help from Chariot of Fire, who's been a
stalwart at the back, knocking people out with the hips.
Yeah.
And Purple Pack has been so strong tonight. It's been one of the stories of the game, no doubt.
Cherry just had her at the back here of the pack and met her again at the front before she finally got out of the pack. That's a tough, tough skate there.
PB Sting still going strong, runs through the pack again, calls off the jam.
As the Angels extend their lead now, almost to 100 points. And Swiss will probably let us know how much time's left if we mention his name. Could be just enough time to finish here.
This will likely be the last jam given the amount of time on the clock.
Hey.
And some strong work at the back. Lil Brookhouse, number 21, takes lead jam. And that must mean our purple jammer is in the penalty box.
Does something happen with the star? Either the jammer didn't have it on or tried to put it on, but she's got an illegal procedure.
I was unable to see at the behind the blockers. So Lil Brookhouse is still out there. She is on a power jam. Light it up for her. This is Gassity's last chance at points. Give her some help, ladies. And fans, give her some cheers. Lil Brickhouse still on her feet. She is working hard out there. That strong purple pack, even though they've only got three skaters out there, still making her do a lot of work. And we'll wait for the call from Swiss Army Roy, but we think that might do it. That does it. So that will be the end of the game officially. We'll wait for the final score tally.
That's the final whistle. Nice push there at the end by Gas City. I think the story of the game was really the power jams. In the first half, Gas City took full advantage of it. Then Angels kept their jammers on the track in the second half, and a couple key blockers really stepped in. Chariot of Fire having a great game, but also couldn't help but notice Petrify, Sweet Oddity, and CC Sickness out there really strong.
Yeah, very strong pack work. And good jamming from both sides, really, but absolutely, I think the name of the game was the packwork from Star this evening.
Yeah, I mean, Hippie Crippler, Chow Mean, of course, Spaz, some good blocking out there as well, with Hoot Nanny and White Rhino. Both teams really showed well today, but your winners tonight in purple, the St. Albert Archangels. Make some noise, ladies and gentlemen. Woo!